guys, welcome back to my channel. As you can see, the Christmas tree and reindeer have made their annual appearance. So that means it's Christmas gift guide time. I wanted to get this out as soon as possible so that if you see anything that sparks an idea, you can get onto it, you know, get organized. We don't want none of that stressy time. Also, if you are in my family, then you might want to turn off the video now unless you potentially want your Christmas gift spoiled this year. Okay, that should be enough time for them to skedaddle. Let's get into it. First up, this is actually a gift from last year. This is what my sister Pierre and I picked out for our other sister Simone, and it is the Miss Dior perfume, the Eau de Parfum. Oh, oh, oh. Ah, this is just a classic scent. It's very feminine, very floral, but very sophisticated. It's not like a little girl scent. As you can see, she's used about, I don't know, maybe a third of it throughout the year. So it's definitely a luxury, something that the person can put on for a special occasion and that they can use throughout the year or years to come. How long does perfume actually last? In my mind, it's like 5 years. I feel like that's what it is. I don't know. And the fun thing is, when we bought this, we actually bought this in store in a department store, and they had an artist there who was painting onto the perfume bottles. I do like the convenience of shopping online, don't get me wrong, but sometimes when you go into stores, they are doing like fun promotional things. Like this was free, you know, that they're just doing in the store for the holiday season. Maybe check out what's happening in local stores and see if they have anything fun like this. Dior are doing free engraving for the holiday season. I also think Jo Malone was doing free engraving. So a nice little personalization, like the painting or the engraving, adds a really nice personal touch to an already beautiful gift. The next item is actually something that I bought for myself off Etsy a few months ago, and it is this Kindle sleeve cover case thing. So it's made of felt, and that is actually hand embroidered stitching there. Isn't it so gorge? The listing actually had a different color on the inside, but I just requested in a message if they could make it pink to match the flowers on the outside, and I love how this turned out. They do make these sleeves in different colorways, and they also make them different sizes for like iPads or tablets or different ebook readers. And this Etsy store also has really cute embroidered hoop art and pouches. Now, speaking of the Kindle cover, the Kindle itself could be a good gift too. In terms of like tech gifts, this is definitely on the more inexpensive side. I am just obsessed with my Kindle. I am a complete Kindle convert. I just read so much more now with the Kindle. It's so much easier to take around. Books are cheaper too because they're ebooks. And then also it has a backlight. It actually lights up. So I was finding when I was reading into the night before, my eyes were getting strained with the poor lighting. So this actually has a light. This is the Kindle Paperwhite, the latest generation. And it's just the 8 GB one. You can get a 32 GB, but like, who needs that? Ebook files are so small, and yeah, I don't know who on earth needs 32 GB, but go off. While we're on the topic of devices and sleeves and covers and all that, this is another cover that I got off Etsy a few years ago for my iPad. And it is a really nice leather with multiple pouches. Oh, that's my little iPad pen pencil thing. And they do emboss them on the bottom. You can get up to 10 letters, which I feel like is quite generous for the amount of letters. You know, brands be stingy these days and be like, you're allowed 3 to 5 letters. So you can get 10 letters. I don't think they do this particular colorway anymore of the pink and blue. I think they just do solid colors, but still, really nice gift. And you can get them in sets. Like they do MacBook covers as well. The MacBook cover, a little leather pouch, a mouse pad, and a cord organizer in the set. Could be a good idea, or you could just get, you know, the cover by itself. The next gift is something that I actually gifted myself, that I splurged on for myself. It is Charlotte Tilbury's holiday lipstick shade for this year. It's actually what I have on right now. The shade is called Rosy Seduction. Seduction. So there it is. And as you can see, when it goes on, it actually throws a little bit warm. It's kind of tiptoeing towards coral, but I actually quite like it. It has a bit of a brightening, well, holiday happy effect. And I also like the idea of a holiday lipstick that isn't red. I don't know why, I just like the idea of rocking the boat there a little bit. Here is the tube as well. I do want to show you that. As you can see, it's got little sparklies all over it. So, definitely glamorous. I do like this. The next gift idea I have is a handbag organizer. This, oh, life changer. I don't think I could go back to using my backpack without this inside of it. So this is made of felt. This gift guide is very felt heavy, but I do like the felt because it's light enough, like it's not gonna weigh your bag down. You know, it's quite malleable and also it's not gonna scratch or damage your bag in any way. So mine has a drink holder in there. Sometimes I do put a water bottle in there, but normally it's just my sunnies. And lots of compartments or pockets around the side that I can pop things in. And also the cool thing about this is you can get these with specific dimensions that match specific bags. For example, if you know somebody has like the Never Full tote, for example, you can get one that matches the dimensions of that tote bag and it will perfectly fit in there. The next idea for a gift is a towel wrap. So this is, it's a towel. Crazy, I know. But it has elastic on the top and also this one has snaps. You can get Velcro ones that fasten up so that when you get out of the shower, it sits there and you don't have to do the awkward rolling and like the unraveling and all of that. The one I have, I actually, that was satisfying. The one I have, I actually got it off like a kawaii merch store and it has the little Sumiko Garashi characters on it. Aren't they so cute? I like this one because it is longer actually than most of these that I found. When I put it on, it sort of goes down to the knee, which is nice. And then it has a snap up the top, but then it also has snaps down the length of it. I was talking to my sister Pierre about how much I love my towel wrap and she was thinking about getting one for herself and she did find this website. It's called Wheezy Towels. And it looks like they have some nice towel wraps on there with the snaps. And they also do sort of towel-y robe things. And then she also found this Etsy listing where you can actually customize the ribbon and also get a name or a monogram embroidered. So thanks, Pia, for finding that. That's a really cute gift idea, a personalized towel wrap. The next idea I have for a gift is a bullet journal kit. There's whole YouTube channels and Instagram pages dedicated to bullet journals. It's a whole thing. It's a community at this point. And I thought this would be a good idea for my sister, Simone. She's very creative. She's a very good drawer. So I feel like bullet journals, definitely something that she could get into. You can buy pre-made bullet journal kits that have all the stuff in it already, but I couldn't really find one that I was really vibing with. So I decided to sort of make my own starter kit with stuff from Amazon. First of all, we have the actual bullet journal. Kind of necessary. Bullet journals are generally A5 and they have dot grid pages. I highly doubt this is going to show up on the camera, but yeah, so it's dot pages. Then I got her a set of markers. This is a pastel watercolor marker set from Primrosia. How cute is that packaging? So this brand, they do watercolor markers. They also do acrylic markers. And then they do lots of different color sets, colorways. I don't feel like she's going to be limited with the shades that are in there. And these pens also, they're dual tip. So one side is like a watercolor brush and then the other side is a fine tip for writing. And then I got her these stencil templates for a bullet journal. So this is a 24 set of templates and it'll just make it quick and easy for her to, you know, do a calendar, to-do lists and bar graphs. Towards the back has like little icons, like the weather that she could do, little florally things. And then yeah, like letters. And I think there was even star signs on here. Yeah, star sign. So yeah, a bullet journal. I hope she likes it. I'm excited to see what she does with it. The last gift idea I have for you is this HB portable printer. This is called a Sprocket. which is the best name ever, Sprocket. This is actually first generation one. They have updated it. You can now get it in different colors, and I'm not actually sure what else is new with the second generation, but it's pretty much the same idea. Basically, you get an app on your phone and then you can Bluetooth across to the printer and it'll print out a little 2x3 photo. You do have to buy specific paper to go in it. But the cool thing about this paper is you can just print it out and have it as a photo, but it also has a sticky back. So you could, you know, use it as a sticker, which is a good idea in conjunction with the bullet journal. You know, you could be printing out photos that you have on your phone and stick it into the bullet journal. So that could be a cool like gift that you could give together. Another cool thing with this is before you print, you can actually customize the photos. So on the app, they have a bunch of borders on there, little stickers that you can add to the photo. You can even write text onto it. So I'm gonna have a go now, and I'm just gonna take this baby photo of Clover. She's so cute. Make it a little bit Christmassy, and then let's send it to the printer and print it out. Your photo will now print. What? I don't know why I'm looking at it and not showing you. Whoops. Okay, and there's our little photo. Yay, there's Clovey Girl. As you can see, it's not like the best quality photo printout ever. You know, it's just like a little portable fun thing. Also, I think because I chose a photo that was very washed out anyway. But yeah, it's very cute for printing out on the go. And like, if you've got a scrapbook or a bullet journal, you can just peel off the back and stick it in there. Actually, maybe that is something that they've updated with the second generation, like better photo quality. I don't know, maybe. Anyway, it's cute for what it is. You know, I'm not expecting it to be like this high res printout. And there is my Christmas gift guide. I hope that something in there sparked a little bit of an idea or something that you could get someone. With gift giving, I do try and buy something that is a little bit of a luxury. You know, something a bit special, but still definitely something that is practical and that the person will get use out of. If you did enjoy today's video, please remember to hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching today, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye-bye.